Welcome to the new session of Laplace Transform. In this session, we shall be discussing about the Laplace Transform of periodic function. Let's start with the Laplace Transform of periodic function. So the formula for the Laplace Transform of periodic function is given by that Laplace of ft, where this ft is a function which is a periodic function and it has a period capital T. So the equation is, the formula is that integral 0 to t e to the power minus st ft dt divided by 1 minus e to the power minus s capital T. So this t capital T is the period of the periodic function. You know that if we draw a sine curve, you know that if we draw the sine curve after an interval of 2 pi, the curve repeats itself. So the sine curve or a cos curve has a period of 2 pi. Therefore, so 2 pi will be regarded as the period which will be represented by capital T. So you can understand the formula that this function ft is a periodic function. It has a certain period capital T. So the formula is integral 0 to t e to the power minus st, where t is the variable, f of t dt divided by 1 minus e to the power minus st, where here this capital T is the period. So now let us discuss about the proof, how this formula has been evolved for the calculation of the Laplace transform of periodic function. Now, we know that the Laplace of a function is given by the definition that it is integral 0 to infinity e to the power minus st ft dt. So we can break our intervals in many parts depending upon the period t it is having. So it is 0 to t e to the power minus st ft dt, and after each t interval we have divided our integrals. So then the next integral is starting from t and the integral is ending up at 2t e to the power minus st ft dt. Similarly, the integral is from now 2t to 3t e to the power minus st ft dt, and so on, and this integral moves on up to infinity. So we have an infinite number of terms where we have break our integrals with t values. So now what we shall be doing now in our derivation, we shall keep this first term as it is. In this second integral, what we shall do, we shall make a substitution that let small t is equal to u plus capital T. And in this third integral, we shall substitute small t is equal to u plus 2 capital T. And for the fourth integral, we should substitute t is equal to u plus 3 capital T, and so on. So when we make the following substitutions in the second integral, that t is equal to u plus t, then if we differentiate this equation, we get dt is equal to du. And if we substitute, we can see in the second integral, the lower limit is small t, capital T, and the upper limit is 2t. So we make that when t is tending to t, so if we substitute t equal to t here, what we get? We get that the u value is tending to 0. So if t is tending to t, then u will tend to 0. And if we substitute t is equal to 2t, then u will tend to t. Therefore, u is tending to t. So we have made the substitutions in the second integral. So what we get? We get that the limits has been changed from 0 to t, e to the power minus st was there. So instead of small t, now we have u plus capital T. We had f of t, so now we have the function f of u plus capital T, and the dt is changed by du. Similarly, if we make consider the third integral, this third integral, we saw that the limits were from 2t to 3t. So we had made the substitution that t is equal to u plus 2t. So when we differentiate again, we get du is equal to dt. For t tending to 2t, then u will be tending to 0. And when t is tending to 3t, then u is tending to capital T. So we make all these substitutions in the third integral, and we have that 0 to t e to the power minus s u plus 2t, f of u plus 2t and du plus so on. So likewise, we shall have the further integrals also. So we know that the function ft was a periodic function. So periodic function means that if we consider a sine function, then sine theta is equal to sine of 2 pi plus theta, sine of 4 pi plus theta and so on. So similarly, if we have the t as the period, then all the functions with the periodic functions, therefore fu will be equal to fu plus t, fu plus 2t, fu plus 3t. So all the functions will be equal and they can be substituted to be equal to f of u. So we make the substitutions. So we have this first integral. The first integral is kept likewise. The second integral, we get that e to the power minus fu, fu du. And since this e to the power minus st does not has any u variable, so this term has been taken out of the integral. Similarly, in the third integral, again f of u plus 2t is substituted f of u because it is a periodic function of t, and e to the power minus 2st capital T is taken outside. So we get that 0 to t e to the power minus su fu du. So now what we see that we can change the variable u by t. U is just representing a variable type. So we can replace our u variable with t variable. So we had replaced our equation with all t's in the equations. So you can see this step. Now you can see that the integral 0 to t e to the power minus st ft dt is common in all the integrals. So we have taken that integral outside. And the terms remaining are 1 plus e to the power minus st plus e to the power minus 2st plus e to the power minus 3st and so on. So as you see this equation, what you see? You see that the bracketed terms is a series. It is an infinite geometric progression series with the first term is this term. The first term is equal to, which is represented by a, small a, and that a is equal to 1. So a is called the first term and its value is 1. And the common ratio, if we divide the subsequent terms with the previous term, so what we find the common ratio. So the common ratio is e to the power minus s capital T. So we know that if we have an infinite GP of infinite terms, where the terms are 1 plus a square, a cube and so on up to infinity. So we have that the resultant formula for the infinite GP is 1 upon 1 minus a. So the resultant formula is a upon a minus r. Therefore, because a was having a value of 1 and r was having the value of a, so the formula becomes 1 upon 1 minus a. So similarly, if we substitute the values in this equation, when we put, so we found that a value is 1 and our r value is e to the power minus of st. So this term leads out to e to the power minus of s capital T. So we have substituted its value and we get the equation as 0 to t integral e to the power minus st ft dt 1 upon e to the power minus s capital T. So in this way, we are able to derive the formula for the Laplace transform of a function where the function was a periodic function and its periodicity was capital T. So this is the formula, and I hope that you have understood how to derive the formula and how we shall be using this formula to calculate the Laplace transform of a periodic function. Problem. So we have to find the Laplace transform of the function where the function defined is ft is t value when the t value is lying between 0 to 1 and its value is 0 when the t is lying between 1 and 2. and we are given that the function of t plus 2 equal to ft. So it is clear from this equation that the function is a periodic function and the period is 2. So after the interval of 2, the nature of the graph will repeat itself and the equation or the function is a periodic function with period 2. So we want to calculate the Laplace transform of a periodic function. So we have this formula, that is integral 0 to t e to the power minus st ft dt upon e to the power minus s capital t. So we shall put the value of t equal to 2. So we have inserted the value. We get the equation 0 to 2 e to the power minus st ft dt upon 1 minus e to the power minus 2s. So now we can break our integral into two parts because the function was divided into two parts. Therefore, we break the interval as 0 to 1 and from 1 to 2, and subsequently we shall insert the values of ft for each interval. So we know that for 0 to 1 interval the function is having a value of t, and for the interval of t lying between 1 to 2 the function f of t has a value of 0. Since the second integral has a value of 0, therefore this equation vanishes, the value is 0. So we are left out with just one integral, and the equation is 1 upon 1 minus e to the power minus 2s integral 0 to 1 e to the power minus st into t dt. So we can apply the UV method of calculation of the integral, or we can integrate by parts. So I am using this formula for calculation of the integral by parts, and we know that integral UV is UV1 minus U dash V2 plus U double dash V3, which means that it is U integral, first integral of the V function minus first derivative of U into double integral of the second function plus double derivative of U function and triple integral of the V function and so on, means that the positive negative signs are getting inverted. So we have applied this formula. So we get e to the power minus 1s upon minus s, or it is t to the power minus st by minus s, e to the power minus st by minus s ka whole square, where the limits we have to apply it is for 0 to 1. So we have applied the limits. So we get this equation. Anything raised to power 0 is 1. And when t, and we solve the equation and we get a resultant of 1 minus e to the power minus s into s plus 1 upon s square into 1 minus e to the power minus 2s. So let's look at another problem of the Laplace transform of a periodic function. So we have to obtain the Laplace transform of the full wave rectified sine wave, where the function is given by ft is sine omega t and the t is lying between 0 to pi by omega. So as the function is defined between the limits of 0 to pi by omega, so the period of this function is pi by omega. So our period capital T is equal to pi by omega. So for T value, we have to substitute T is equal to pi by omega. So we take the definition of the periodic function. So definition of the periodic function was that Laplace of ft is 1 minus e to the power minus st. So for t we have substituted pi by omega. Then integral 0 to capital T, again we have substituted pi by omega for capital T, e to the power minus st ft dt, and we know that the function value is sine omega t, so we have substituted sine of omega t in place of ft and dt. Now we can see this is a form of e to the power ax sine of bx. So we will have the formula e to the power ax upon a square plus b square a sine bx minus of b cos bx. So if we compare this equation, we can find that a value is here our minus s and the b value is omega. So for A, we shall be substituting minus S, and for B, we shall be substituting omega. So we have that e to the power minus st minus s ka whole square, that is s square, b ka whole square is omega square, a sine omega t corresponds to minus s sine omega t, and minus b cos bt is minus omega cos omega t, and the limits are from 0 to pi by omega. So the rest is just the calculation part. We have to insert the upper limit and the lower limit. So in place of t, we have substituted first pi by omega, and then we shall substitute the zero value. So we have done these calculations. You can see here, we know sine 0 is 0 and cos 0 is 1. So we get our result as omega is taken out common. So omega upon s square plus omega square into 1 plus e ki power minus s pi by omega into 1 minus of e ki power minus s pi by or minus s pi by 2 omega common from both numerator and denominator. So we get the resultant as e ki power s pi by 2 omega plus e ki power minus s pi by 2 omega upon e ki power s pi by 2 omega into e ki power minus of s pi by 2 omega. And we have divided our equation by 2 so that we can substitute it for the hyperbolic cos and sine functions. So we have that this equation is equal to pi upon s square plus omega square into hyperbolic cos s pi by 2 omega into hyperbolic sine s pi by 2 omega, and we know that hyperbolic cos upon hyperbolic sine is equal to hyperbolic cotangent function. So we get the answer as pi upon s square plus omega square into hyperbolic cotangent s pi by 2 omega. So in this way, we are able to calculate the Laplace transform of a full rectified sine wave. So please, you have to just see in this equations that what is the period capital T. If you can judge the value of capital T correctly, then no one can stop you to get a correct answer.